It's been a long time since I came up to my channel and spoke to you guys, and that is why my Instagram DMs as well as YouTube comment section is filled with the questions which I'm not able to reply back to you because as you all know that I'm an official MDS practitioner now, and I've started working since last 2 months, so I've been quite busy with all that tensions and stuff, so that is why I'm not being very consistent on my channel. So I thought, why not come up here and speak to you guys and reply to all those questions here. That will be better, and that will be in that way I can explain better rather than typing to each and every message, which will be very time taking. So yeah, I thought, why not make a video, and as you all can see in the thumbnail and also in the title, that what this video is gonna be about. So this video is gonna be about BDS and MDS, say that dentistry as a career option. The purpose of making this video is also because of the counseling which is going on. Even NEET UG result have come a few weeks back, and people are really confused about what to do, whether to take BDS or MBBS, or they are really confused even if they are getting BDS. Is BDS good enough? Because they hear a lot of outside noise telling them that it's a wrong career choice. And also NEET MDS counseling is also going on, so that is why I think I am getting a lot of questions on my DMs. So yeah, I think this is the very right time to make this video. So I'm gonna tell you guys one by one, and whatever I am saying is based on my experience, and it can actually vary according to people. Many of you might not agree to what I'm saying. So guys, couple of weeks back, I was actually receiving a lot of hate kind of comment on my DM section for dental profession, and that was the time when I was in very low phase of my life, because you guys know that initially whatever you start, because that was the time when I had freshly graduated as an MDS, and I was struggling to get consultations and even to find a clinic to work in. So when I was getting such demotivating messages, it was quite depressing, you know. I wanted to really come and speak about it, but I didn't have that energy to even open a camera and shoot a video. I hope you can understand. I am in much better phase after 2 months. So I thought, why not come here and talk to you guys. And so now I'm gonna read out the questions. So the first question is that, I am thinking of taking a BDS college, so please can you tell me the scope of BDS and how much we can earn and stipend. So guys, you are just joining BDS as a first year student, and I think it is too early to think about stipend and also to think about how much you are gonna earn. Obviously money is important, but getting skill and to learn things is most important, and money should not be the end goal of any career, whatever you take. That is what I feel. I have studied dentistry for almost 8 to 9 years, and you know, I never thought about money or how much I'm gonna earn during that time. I knew that that will happen eventually, but my goal or my motto was only to think about how I can learn things and how I can sharpen my skill. I feel that that should be your goal, no matter what career choice you are taking up. Be it MBBS, BDS or anything, I think money should not be your goal at first. If you enter as a student just thinking about the money you are gonna make, then I feel that is very sad mental. Stipend you are gonna get only if you join a purely government college, and even if you get a government seat in private college, you are not gonna get stipend in most of the colleges. Only few colleges are there which I might give you stipend, especially deemed universities. Deemed university, if you join any deemed university, they might give you stipend, but most colleges do not give stipend if you join a private college, even if you get a government seat. And again, I feel stipend should not be your one and only goal when it comes to choosing college, because stipend is what you are gonna get only a year, and it's not gonna be linked to what you are gonna earn or what where you're gonna work again after BDS. So again, do not think only about stipend when you are joining college. Next question, which I'm gonna read now, I think which is gonna cover most of the questions. What is the scope after BDS in your state? Does it has government support? Will you be shifted to government hospital? If you open a private clinic, what would be the monthly salary? Will it cover the loan for clinical setup? Can BDS student can get a job? And what would be the income if a BDS student join a private hospital? And I don't think even a private hospital need a dentist nowadays. So please make a video on this and also make your honest discussion, which one is better, BDS or bumps after MBBS? Can bumps students can get a better future of BDS depending upon the current situation in India? First thing I want to tell you guys is that take dentistry as your career option if only you are passionate about it, and if only you really want to be a dentist and you really want to help people getting a better healthy smile. Do not take up dentistry just because your parents are forcing, or just because you want to wear white coat or get a prefix of doctor before your name, or just because being a doctor was your childhood dream, and just because you could not get through MBBS. All such decisions can really have a big impact in your life or your career as a dentist. You can really regret. So please do think well before taking it up as your career. Are you really interested? Are you really gonna give your 100% to what you are doing or what you are gonna do now? Think about it. I have seen many people who have succeeded in this career and many people who could not continue it after 1 or 2 years. So decision is yours, choice is yours. Think and make a decision. Do not rush into it. Another thing which we get to hear a lot is that dentistry has reached a saturation point and we do not need a dentist anymore in any private hospitals, even in government sector or even dental clinics, because you know, dentists are more and patients are less, apparently. This is what a common man thinks nowadays. What I feel is that India is in need of more dental health awareness, because it is one of the countries where oral cancer is one of the most common cancer among people. Still, people are unaware about the ill effect of tobacco. Most of them are tobacco chewers, and they do not get a proper facility in rural areas, and they are not accessible to dentists, these rural people. So I have taken out the study in which I have tried to see the dentist to population ratio of India, and according to what it was shown, it is shown that there is one dentist available for 10,000 people in urban areas, whereas 1.5 lakh is in rural area. That means that one dentist is available for 1.5 lakh people in rural areas, and ratio is self-explanatory now. And also, India is one of the country, if you don't know that, which is in top 5 of the highest number of oral cancer in this world. And even in India, oral cancer is one of the most common cancer among the population, Indian population. And I think not any other country but our own country needs more awareness and more dentists. So it is definitely true that there are very few vacancies for dentists in government sector, and yes, we need more of government support to survive in government sector being a dentist. The next thing we're going to discuss is setting up your own clinic or private practice is expensive. So one thing I want to tell you guys before taking up BDS is that BDS is investment. No matter what you join, whether it is a private college or government college, obviously the fees in government college, fee structure in government college is very, very less and minimal. But still, I feel is that dentistry is investment, because even in government college, you need to get your own instruments and you need to buy few materials and books of your own, which is gonna be very expensive. So in that way, even not even talking about the fees, you are only buying instruments and material, and also your books can also be very very expensive. So same way, if you open a private clinic, you gonna have to invest at least from 5 to 10 lakhs for a minimal setup, okay? And if you open that clinic and if you start a clinic in an area where the patient flow is good, then you can get it back very soon, whatever you have invested, and it's not gonna be at loss for sure. Because what I have seen in the past few months is that yes, that is do earn a lot if their practice is good. And most of the dentists I have seen, they are doing very well. So yeah, this is what is the truth. And here one more thing has been mentioned is that I don't think even a private hospital need a dentist nowadays. But most of the good hospitals, even in my town where I am residing right now, which is my hometown, and also in the nearby towns, the good hospitals have their dental units and there are dentists hired there. So the next question is that pa nijor dental clinic khulan plan asene. So I'm not very good in Assamese, so I'm not going to reply in Assam. So right now I'm not even thinking of starting my own dental clinic, because being an orthodontic graduate, if we get good consultation, it is well and good. We do not really need our own dental setup because we'll be very busy with the consultations itself. But I've just started getting, so I hope if I get a consultation in this flow, I will not have to open a dental clinic of my own very soon. But obviously I will be in need of my own clinic in future, which I will open hopefully after a year or two. So yeah, let's hope for the best and please do pray for me. Question here is that can BAMS students can get a better future or BDS depending? I do not want to compare our profession with any other profession in which I have zero knowledge about. I have really no idea about the situation in Ayurvedic field, so I don't want to make any comment in that. Okay. So guys, this is the few things which I wanted to discuss with you all in this video. There are still a lot of other things and topics which is needed to be discussed in the next videos which I will be making. And if you have any other video requests related to dentistry as well, please do request in our comment section and I will see accordingly and make the videos. And I have not made this video to just talk positive things about dentistry, but this is what I feel about dentistry. And one thing I want to tell you guys is that I have never regretted taking up dentistry as a career. And I don't know how it is for others. Never get demotivated no matter what others says. I have faith in myself and my ability. Right now I am just in my initial phase of my journey in clinical practice, but my inside voice tells me I'm on the right path and I want to really listen and believe in my inner voice. So yeah, this is what it is. I hope you enjoy this video and please do not forget to give big thumbs up and also subscribe to my channel if you still haven't.